Hello, Earthlings. John with you, aka Kaiwaza. Welcome back to my channel. And the next edition in a series that I always look forward to now, The Cheap Lounge. So welcome to The Cheap Lounge. Pull up a chair, get yourself a beverage, and let's see what's spinning at The Cheap Lounge. This is the series where I discuss the albums, vinyl records, and CDs that I have uploaded over the past week or so onto my online easy listening radio station called Moody Mood Music on live365.com. It's free 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can be lulled into sweet unconsciousness by the Musik of the past. It's fueled by cheap dollar records that I find in dollar record bins and thrift stores and library sales and whatever, all over the place. If it's like a dollar, around a dollar, I'm gonna get it. As long as it's in our genre. So, five things to show you today. So let us get started. First album up is the Phase 4 Stereo out of England. Evergreen by Ronnie Aldrich, his pianos and orchestra. This record is from 1977, and I'm sure you'll notice that it says Ronnie Aldrich, his pianos, plural, and orchestra. So what's the deal with that? Well, the deal is Ronnie Aldrich, in the 60s primarily, and into the 70s, as we see here, recorded many albums. He was a British, played piano. And his shtick, if you want to call it that, was the twin pianos, or two pianos. So almost all of his record albums feature two pianos with an orchestra. Now, you might think in your head, okay, Ferrante and Teicher, right? That was their thing. That was two guys playing two pianos. And yes, they were before Ronnie Aldrich. Ferrante and Teicher really started off in the 50s. So by the time Ronnie Aldrich came around in 1960, early 60s, yeah, the whole idea of twin pianos was happening. There were other imitation people doing like twin pianos. Even the Living Strings put out some budget RCA Camden records of like Living Strings with the twin pianos. So it was a sound that people were familiar with, and Ronnie Aldrich capitalized on that and did beautiful recordings. Very nice, very classy, most of them. Recordings of, I'm getting weather like alerts on my phone. We've had some flash flooding and stuff over the past week, and I guess there's another one maybe that's gonna happen today. So this may be my last broadcast coming to you with my record collection. I'm on the first floor, so if we have a gigantic flash flood, I think everything might float out to sea. So enjoy Ronnie Aldrich while you can. Anyway, this is, Ronnie Aldrich walked into the twin pianos was already a known concept, but he just really capitalized on that. This album I like. You know, the 70s, I love some of the songs are amusing to me. Dancing Queen, you know, to hear a ABBA redone with the twin pianos. That theme from King Kong, obviously the 1970s King Kong version. Evergreen, you know that song. So interesting stuff on here, and this is a very nice album and a nice addition to Moody Mood Music. Next up, it's a RCA Victor record from 1966. This is the Norman Luboff Choir with that Latin, the Latin Luboff, I should say. The Latin Luboff.
You only answer.
Quizás, quizás, quizás. If you can make your mind up, we'll never get started. And I don't want to wind
this
up.
This is Mr. Luboff right here.
Broken-hearted.
Now, I will say, it's interesting, as far as like easy listening music goes, I always refer to Ray Conniff as sort of the definitive sound. A lot of his, well, he did instrumentals, but specifically a lot of his vocal group albums are very distinctive and very, to me, like quintessential of the easy listening format. It hasn't been until lately that I've been amassing a lot more easy listening albums and listening to a lot more and having the Moody Mood Music Station for over a little over a year now that I've kind of come to realize that Norman Luboff is also a very signature easy listening sound. I mean, not necessarily distinctive, but just his arrangements and his approach in these choirs, it's very easy listening. Like this is a Latin album, but it's not like some cha-cha record or, you know, something crazy and exotic. It's not. It's a very mainstreamed, easy listening, lovely Latin music. And this one features Lorindo Almeida, famous guitarist, on guitar in these songs. I particularly like the song Sunset and Moonrise, which Norman Luboff wrote for this album and was actually covered later on by a Hawaiian group. That's how I knew it. The Ali'is covered Sunset and Moonrise, but I like that song.
Just like sunset and moonrise.
So yeah, this was a nice addition. Interestingly, my exposure to Norman Luboff had been a little bit more limited before the easy listening stuff, actually collecting the stuff. I had the Hawaiian record, Aloha from Norman Luboff, forever, and it's exactly the same picture of him too. I just realized that. But this is a strange record. This is not at all a typical like choral, what you would think of Hawaiian easy listening record. I mean, there's some really upbeat, crazy stuff on here. There's a lot of Tahitian songs. Not just Hawaiian songs, but a lot of Tahitian songs and songs where the rhythm is really strange. It's kind of a wacky, whacked out record. I like it, but it's not typical Hawaiian. It's not typical Hawaiian easy listening. But most of his other material definitely is in that really nice, easy listening vein.
Haven't you heard? Everything old is new again. If you want to keep up to date in the latest and greatest in music trends, you'd better listen to Moody Mood Music on live365.com. You know, that's where all the hip and groovy people go. All the cool cats hang out at Moody Mood Music. Join us there and keep up to date. Moody Mood Music, live365.com.
Vocalist Tommy Sands. This is a 1959 record on Capitol. This thing called Love.
When each weary day is through, how I long to be with you.
A lot of kind of standards on this record. I really, really enjoyed this album. Tommy Sands, I'm not that familiar with as a singer. I have to tell you, from my own experience, I do know who Tommy Sands was, but it was because he was living in Hawaii when I moved here in 1981. He was the radio host of a show I used to listen to every week called the Hawaii Top 40 Countdown. It was the top 40 songs on KKUA, which was more of an adult contemporary sort of station, as opposed to the Hawaii Weekly Top 30, which I also listened to, which was on KIKI, which was very, you know, pop, a younger oriented. So their charts were kind of different. Some songs the same and some kind of different, but I used to listen to him all the time. I didn't really know who he was until much later on. I'm like, I don't know who Tommy Sands was. Of course, that was pre-internet and all of that, but nice album. A lot of classic songs on this. He started out really as a teenage heartthrob. He was kind of a teenage idol, and then kind of matured, recorded several albums, has a beautiful voice. Really, I love the arrangements on this album. Love the arrangements. And in Married Nancy Sinatra, was on some television shows, some film work he did. He was, you know, getting around, doing quite well. Was married to Nancy Sinatra, and then in 1965, he divorced Nancy Sinatra, and strangely, immediately following the divorce, all of his opportunities shut the door. He couldn't get any work in films, couldn't get any work recording or doing television or whatever. And he eventually then moved to Hawaii and did some things here, had a nightclub here for a while and did some entertaining, but yeah. Interesting, divorcing Nancy Sinatra. And then divorcing her, and I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Connect the dots. All right, now up next, we have a very large boxed set of albums. Now, this is from Reader's Digest. It is from 1964. It's very heavy. It's called Mood Music for Dining. I had digitized some of this and put some selections on quite a bit earlier, but I hadn't finished it. But this week I finished up and put on some more music from this lovely, beautiful box set from 1964, Reader's Digest, by many, many different artists. I should tell you also, before I get too far into this, if you are into these things, these box sets, I am. I think they're really cool. There were a million of them done. There is a Facebook page that you should check out called Vintage Vinyl, Vintage Vinyl Box Set Enthusiast. Sorry, I thought somebody was knocking on my door. It's very close, so the doors are very close to each other. Vintage Vinyl Box Set Enthusiast on Facebook. Lots of discussion about these box sets. It's run by my friend Scott, so go check it out because it's fun and a lot of discussion about these box sets. But this one has 10 records, 1964. It's huge. I did a video on it earlier, quite a while ago, which I'll link up here, a whole video on it. So I'm not going to talk too much about it today, but a million different artists. Every side of the album has a particular theme, like Cocktail Piano Time, Romantic Gypsy Violins, South of the Border, Tropical Nights. And in addition to that, this is really funny. And this is the only example of this I've seen. They did something called pleasure programming, and they would say, sometimes they would print it in the little booklets that came, like, if you play record one, side three, with record three, side two, and list this program, it could be like a certain program, like music for a quiet evening at home reading, music for, you know, playing bingo or whatever. Well, this one, this is the only example of this I've ever seen. They actually did a printed out little programmer. Again, I talk about this more in the other video, but you can slide it to lift your spirits, and then it gives you a short program if you want to play it that way, or a longer program. So this is funny. The music is all lovely on this set. Very, very definitely quality. I mean, Reader's Digest and Longines Symphonette, they didn't mess around. You know, they had quality. The music was such quality. It's great. Finally, we are going to talk about a CD that I've had for quite some time that I uploaded this week. It's called Salon Music by the Palm Court Orchestra. This is on the label Selected Sound out of Germany. Now, so what is salon music? Salon music is music that was played in, I'll read you exactly what they say. Yes, entertainment and dance music during the end of the 19th century in health resorts, hotels, gardens, cafes, Berlin, Paris, London, Vienna, Dresden. So it's in those kind of settings, you know, where people are sitting around in the beautiful hotel setting or whatever, having tea and sandwiches and whatever. And this was the kind of polite cocktail music of its day, salon music, coffee houses. Now, what they don't tell you, and contrary to what you might realize, is these are not actually old recordings from that time period. These are all recorded, the songs are recorded between 1979 and 1991. The CD came out in 1991. And the composers, I checked this out, were all 20th century people that were living in the 20th century. So all of the songs on here, and there's quite a number of songs, rather 18, all of them are not from the era of salon music, but they are salon music style compositions that are just like what they would have played. So very pleasant, very nice, sort of, you know, lightly classical, if you will. And this brand, this label, is interesting to me also. Selected Sound out of Germany. What they did were production records. I don't know if you're familiar with that, but Selected Sound was actually a production music or a library music company. They produced music that was not intended to be played on the radio or purchased in the store. They were production albums of music that were intended to be used in TV commercials, in, you know, documentary series, in films, in any sort of special thing, commercials or whatever that you were producing where you didn't want to use known music or didn't have to pay the copyright on known kind of songs or whatever. So these companies created this music. And there's many, many in the series. I love production music, library music. I love to get it when I can. It's usually not cheap, so. But I did get this one, which I've had for quite some time, Selected Sound by the same company, Hawaii and South Pacific. And I love this. This was used in SpongeBob SquarePants in the early seasons. You can hear a lot of music from this one. And it's crazy, over the top. I love it. But yeah, salon music is very pleasant, very nice to listen to. I think very appropriate. Interesting titles, you know, different era, so to speak. But Old Vienna Soiree, Cream and Candy, Café Belvedere, Hotel Bristol, Petite Ballerina, Tea with Alice. So yeah, I uploaded quite a few selections from this onto the station as well. That's it for this week. So I hope you enjoyed that. If you have a chance or are interested, please check out Moody Mood Music or Hawaiian Hi-Fi on live365.com. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you want to see more, and leave any comments. And by the way, if I would really recommend, if you're interested, to go back and look at the previous Cheap Lounge episodes, because we do carry on conversation in the comments, and there are viewers and subscribers and people that will comment and contribute actually additional information. So it's kind of really interesting to go, if you haven't, to go back to those videos and read the comment section about what's been said. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.